எடுக்க எடுக்க. ஹலோ, நான் இக்கடி வந்தால் நீ இக்கடிக்கு திறக்க. நில்லு பாய்ங்க, நில்லு, ஃபோக்கஸ்
மாதிரியும்.
ஹலோ, குட் மார்னிங் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். இந்த எஸ்டர்டேஸ் கிளாஸ் ஐ எக்ஸ்பிளைன் ஹவு டு டிட்டர்மின் த பர்சன்டேஜ் கம்போஷன் ஆஃப் அன்னோன் லிக்விட் மிக்சர் யூசிங் ரிஃப்ராக்டோமீட்டர் வித் ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் எ ஃபார்முலா, தட் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆஸ் ஃபார்முலா மெத்தட். ஓகே, அண்ட் டுடே ஐ வுட் லைக் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் ஹவு டு டிட்டர்மின் the percentage composition of liquid mixture using the same refractometer with help of a graph, that is called as graphical method of determination of percentage composition. And look here, this is actually the tabular column. In the tabular column we are having five tables. One is a liquid, percentage of A, density of D, and refractive index and specific refractivity. Here we are given the liquids, pure liquid A, it is pure liquid A, it is benzene, it is 100% of benzene. Liquid B is means a pure CCl4, it is containing 0% of benzene. M1 is a mixture of benzene and CCl4, is containing 30% of A. M2 is again a mixture of A and B, whose percentage composition is 60% of A. M3 is again a liquid mixture containing A and B, whose the percentage composition of A is 60%, like this. And finally, we are having unknown liquid mixture C, the percentage composition of A is unknown. And our aim is, we have to determine the percentage composition of unknown liquid mixture with the help of this refractometer using a graph. Hence, this method is called as a graphical method. Yes. For this one, we are given the liquids. This is liquid A, pure benzene. It is liquid B, pure CCl4. It is liquid mixture M1. M1 is a mixture of A and B, and it is containing, say, 30% of A. M2 is a mixture of A and B, containing 40% of A. And M3 is a mixture of again A and B, is containing 60% of A and B, A. And in addition to these liquids, we are given one more liquid mixture, that is liquid mixture C. Here, the liquid mixture C is containing the A and B, and percentage composition of A is unknown. Our aim is to calculate or to determine the percentage of the liquid mixture that is present in this mixture in terms of A using the refractometer by using the graph. Yes, for this one, as usual, first the prism table is opened like this. It is cleaned thoroughly by means of a dry cotton plug. Then place few drops of liquid A. Place few drops of liquid A on the prism table with help of the glass tube, and close the prism table and open the door here. After placing the liquid mixture here, the instrument is closed. That is, the prism table is closed. It is locked. And here is a knob, this lower knob. This knob is called a main knob. It is called as a compensator knob. So first, looking through the eyepiece, move the main knob slowly, either in the clockwise or in the anti-clockwise manner, till we get a colored band of this type. As soon as you get a colored band of this type, by using this knob, that is called as the upper knob, it is called as compensator knob. This knob is moved slowly
either in the clockwise manner or in the anti-clockwise manner till you get a dark band that is called as half shadow, like this. As soon as you get a half shadow, immediately again move the main arm either in the clockwise or in the anti-clockwise manner, so that the dark band, the center of the dark band should be coincides with the center of the crosswire, and stop the movement. And just below the screen there is a scale marked like this. Here there are two important scales. One is refractive index and another is percentage composition. So here we have to calculate the refractive index of the given liquid. Looking through the eyepiece, on the just above the or just below the screen, a scale is marked like this, and get the refractive index value of liquid A. After taking the reading, again the prism table is opened. Prism table is opened, and it is cleaned thoroughly by means of a dry cotton plug, and again place 2 drops of the liquid B on the prism table. Okay, and close the prism table. Close the prism table and lock it as usual. And again, repeat the same thing till first we get a crowd band, and then we're getting a half shadow, and adjust the center of dark band exactly center of the crosswire and get the reading. This reading is but the refractive index value of liquid B. Like this, repeat the similar procedure to get the refractive index value of M1, M2, M3 as well as unknown liquid mixture. Yes sir, after taking the refractive index values of A, B, M1, M2, M3, M4 as well as C, here we are given density values of A is given, density of B is given, M1, M2, M3, M4, etc. The densities of all the liquids are given, except the density of unknown liquid is not given. So here you have to calculate or determine the density of liquid mixture C by following the observations as given below. First, take the weight of empty specific gravity bottle, let it be 1 grams. After taking the weight, the gravity bottle is filled with liquid mixture C completely and stopper it. And take weight of empty gravity bottle plus liquid mixture C, let it be 2 grams. Then take the difference of these two, that is weight of mixture C is equal to W2 minus W1, that is equal to some value. After taking the weight, the liquid mixture C is removed from the bottle, gravity bottle, and it is dried again, and it is filled completely with water. Then take weight of empty gravity bottle with water, let it be 3 grams. Then take the weight of water, that is equal to W3 minus of W1, that is equal to some grams. After taking weight of mixture and weight of water, find the density of liquid mixture C. Density of mixture C is equal to weight of mixture by weight of water, that gives density of liquid. Yes sir, after knowing density and also by knowing refractive index, calculate the specific refractivity using the formula, that is R is equal to N square minus 1 divided by N square plus 2 into 1 by density. Yes sir, after calculating the specific refractivity values, you just simply plot a graph of specific refractivity values along y-axis and percentage of A along x-axis. So, by plotting graph of specific refractivity versus percentage of A, we are getting a straight line of this type. A straight line is obtained like this. And by knowing the specific refractivity of unknown liquid mixture, that is, you mark the specific refractivity on the y-axis. So suppose it may be somewhere here, and from this point, draw a parallel line and draw a perpendicular line where it cuts from on the line
and that gives the percentage of liquid mixture C in terms of A. Like this, we can determine the percentage composition of the unknown liquid mixture C in terms of A using the refractometer with the help of graph. Like this, we can determine the percentage composition. It is all about this experiment. Okay, thank you.